Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think yesterday we have discussed about the plus Sabine Canadin E. The summary of the Sabine Canadin E, we have discussed all these things, whatever we have learned, that in the section number 1, because we are studying the course number CCTP 10, previously known as CH450. The name of that course is a chemistry of natural products. Why it is essential to study such a natural product? What is the purpose of introducing such kind of the contain at MSc level? That I have discussed during my 1st lecture, as well as I have explained the nature of the question paper, that is credit system, choice based credit system, from July 2020. This syllabus is introduced by Savitribai Phule, Pune University, Pune. And so far we have completed one of the section, whatever molecules for study for the syllabus, we have discuss one after one with their full explanation. But due to the time limit, we cannot cover multiple choice question, because we are facing, whole world is facing the pandemic, which is COVID-19. After completion of the section 2, I will again start the section from section 1, multiple choice questions. So before that, we are going to discuss today, we are going to start today is a section number 2, that is MSc Organic Chemistry Semester 4, CCTP 10, CHO 450, Chemistry of Natural Products. In the section 2, the weightage of section 2 is a 2 credit, as well as this belong to it require 12 lectures to complete, and there are the 6 tutorials. So online tutorials you can complete. So and here in the section 2, there are the 2 molecules. One is a vanucel and second one is a pinaic acid. These are the 2 molecules with their full description, full details we are going to learn in this section. So it is, and it has a credit, 2 credit. So you have to, if you want to get as a 2 credit, you have to listen these lectures carefully, and it will help you in your future to achieve, to get the 2 credits. Now, see over here, the first point we are going to discuss, that is the venous cells A and B. Venous cells is nothing but they are the natural product, because the name itself suggests that we are learning as a chemistry of a natural product. Why we are learning as a chemistry of a natural product? What is the purpose behind it? Because the recent days, how these natural products are helpful, because they exhibit, they shows important biological activities such as antibacterial, antifungal, antimalarial, antioxidant, antidepression, antioxidant, anti-HIV, antidepression, antimalarial, antifungal, antipsychotoxic, antihypertensive, and so on, and therefore anti-cancer, and therefore we have to synthesize these natural products are generally obtained from various parts of the plants, and they exhibit the biological activity just now I mentioned, and therefore the modern scientists are trying, and nowadays recently whole world is facing one pandemic, which is COVID-19, first wave, second wave, then now in coming days, upcoming days, the third wave is going to come, but still there is a trial and trial basis. All the world scientists are trying to find out the medicine on it, but still today there is no medicine which can control these diseases completely, or whatever vaccines available till today, all are not the 100% effective. Some of them are 60%, 70%, 91%. Still, there is no single vaccine which can effectively control this disease, and therefore these kind of the natural product one day will come, one of them may be effective against this disease, and we will be free, because nowadays the whole world is fearing due to this pandemic, and we are going under, the whole world is going under very fear atmosphere. There is no freedom nowadays. There are lot of restrictions. So you have to adopt, or you have to follow appropriate behavior such as you always wear the mask, sanitize regularly, and keep the social distance, and these are the appropriate you should or everyone should follow. So such type of the tremendous stress on every sector or the society, there is a lot of fear is there. So the scientists nowadays, they are trying, one day will come, will the natural product will find the, because every problem has the solution. So the scientists will, I hope scientists will one day succeed in finding the medicine on that COVID-19, and we will be free from that. So that's why such a type of the natural products we are studying. So here in the section second, these articles, generally venusels A and B, is nothing but as a natural product. There, what are their structure, what is the target molecule, and as we know that target molecule is the thing, but the molecule whose synthesis being planned is called as a target molecule. And you can observe that target molecule very carefully and find out there are certain criteria to observe the target molecule, and then think logically to go backward toward the starting compound in a chemical reaction on the paper first, and then you do the actual synthesis in the laboratory, and once that succeed, you have to do like this. So such kind of the work scientists are doing day to day in their life, and they are trying to find out such a type of the molecules with their detailed information, spectral data, or whatever instrumental analysis they have carried out, and they are matching with the theoretical data. If the agreements are matched, theoretical as well as whatever they have carried out practically, then and then they confirm that this molecule, which is isolated from the plant, is exactly which they have prepared in the laboratory. So nowadays modern technologies are available, we can get as much as information, accurate information from this modern technologies. So the author who synthesized these molecules, the little information regarding these, who started that, the history of that also given in that. So in the syllabus, so these articles, these research papers article is published in JAKS. JAKS is a short form or the acronym. The full form of that JAKS or this article, the J stand for journal, A stand for American, C stand for chemical, and S stand for the society. The full name of this JAK is nothing but the Journal of American Chemical Society. And in the syllabus, A part is given Venusus. References are given Journal of American Chemical Society, which was published in 2010, volume number 132, page numbers 7138 to 7152, nearly 15 pages. This article, all the detailed information are given in that we are going to learn step by step what is given there and what type of the thinking power we can develop from this. Second reference is given, again Journal of American Chemical Society, which is also published in 2010, volume number 132, and page number is 7153 to 7176, near about 24 pages articles. Then third reference is given, Angiochem International Edition 2019, volume number 48, page numbers are given 5642 to 5647, near about 6 pages are there. Then fourth reference is given, Angiochem Chemical International Edition 2000. This paper was published in 2009, volume number 48, page numbers are 5648 to 5652, near about 5 pages are there. In the second means B part, B molecule, that is a pinaic acid. Pinaic acid references are given again as the articles or the journals names are given, Angiochem Chemical International Edition. This paper was published in 2001, volume number 40, 23. Then page numbers are given 4452 to 4452, near about 3 pages. Then second reference is given, Angiochem Chemical International Edition 2001, volume number 40, 23, page number also given 4453 to 4456, near about 4 pages. Third reference also given, Angiochem International Edition. This paper was published in 2007, volume number 46, page numbers are given 5746 to 5749 = 4. So title of this paper was Total Synthesis and Structural Revision of Venusus A and B. What is the title of this? Title must be this. Title of this is a total synthesis and structural revision of Venusus A and B. Venusus A and B, this is a heading given to that. A and B, synthesis of the originally assigned, here. Further, total synthesis and structural revision of Venusus A and B. Then synthesis of the originally assigned structure of Venusus B.
venusal B.
Venusal B. That is the heading of this paper. Total synthesis and structural revision of venusals A and B means synthesis of the originally assigned structure of venusals B. And this paper was published by K.C. Nikulu, that is the main or the star author, we can call it as, by K.C. Nikolos Nikolu Nikolu N-I-C-O-L-O-L-A-O-U Nikolu. Then Andrian Artis, Hong Zhang, Philippe Dangnew, Andreas Lemwer, Michael P. Jennings, Stelios, Arseniadis, Raphaelia Ferrani, and Demetrius Elizos, and they have given the apparatus here, the abstract, the total synthesis of the originally assigned structure of venusal B2 and its diastereomers D2 are described here. Now let us see what could be the originally assigned structure of venusal A and venusal B. Structure number 1 and structure number 2 that we are going to see over here. So this is a somewhat brief introduction we have seen, but let us see the structures, how many rings are present over there. So let's see, let's observe this structure carefully. Once you see this molecule, this is the molecule which I am showing over here. So look at, it's very easy to find out its structure. So this is the structure I am showing over here, you can see properly and try to find out the molecule which I am showing over here, OH, here will be OH, here the OH should be above the plane, here you can write OAC, acetyl group, and here the hydroxy which is below the plane. The stereochemistry plays an important role here. So just see here, I am showing O acetyl group here. One of the group which is attached over here, this is a propyne group. Now at this junction, the hydrogen atom which is above the plane, at this junction the hydrogen atom should be below the plane. At this junction the hydrogen atom which is shown over here, it should be below the plane, there is a double bond, and at this junction there is a one groove, and this is a what we can call it as aldehyde group that goes below the plane. 1, 2, 3, 4 already there. Okay, and now so all the stereochemical structures we have drawn over here, if you see this structure carefully, you will find here this is a structure number 1, which is known as vanucel A. This is known as a vanucel A. This is a structure of vanucel A. We'll compare, then let's see the structure of vanucel B, which I am writing, which I am representing over here. This is a structure which I am showing over here. This is a, now here is a 6-membered ring, and then further attached with 5-membered ring. Then there is another 5-membered ring which is attached like this. Here are one more 5-membered ring which is joined over here like this, and there is a one groove that is a tertiary alcohol which is shown over here. Here is a one groove, hydroxy groove, here also hydroxy groove, at this junction also hydroxy groove, 1, 2, 3 and 4 hydroxy groups are there. At this here, as we know, it is similar to that. Here is one of the acetyl group which is below the plane. Now here is a hydrogen atom, it should be above the plane. At this junction the hydrogen atom should be below the plane. Here is a double bond, here the hydrogen atom, it is below the plane. Now here one of the group which is once again below the plane, that is a aldehyde group. And now see the structure. If you observe, this is a structure, structure number 2, which is known as a vanucel, vanucel B. This is a structure of vanucel B. I am writing here structure number 1, that is a vanucel, vanucel A, vanucel A, and this is a structure of second structure which is vanucel, vanucel B. So these are the two structures which I have shown on the blackboards. So what is the major difference? If you see the carbon framework, you will find there are C13 carbon framework. C13 carbon framework, or what we can call it as a carbon atoms are present in that. And the major difference, look at here. Here is a acetyl group and here is a hydrogen atom. That hydrogen atom and this acetyl group is the major difference between vanucel A and vanucel B. Understood this one? This is the difference when you try to find out the major difference between venusal A and venusal B both are the same, but only here, let me make the correction. Here the stereochemistry remains as it is. Here hydroxy group above the plane, acetyl group also as above the plane, but here is a hydroxyl group, here is a acetyl group. That is a major difference between, or it is a one of the way we can differentiate between A and B, venusal A and venusal B. Venusal A has acetyl group at this point, whereas there is a hydroxy group. So let us see that one. And it is again, this is a target molecule, and target molecule, we know that in the retrosynthesis or disconnection approach, we know that it is a, what we can call it as a target molecule whose synthesis being planned is called as a target molecule. And if you see how many chiral centers are present, chiral center are the chiral stereo centers are present over there. If you find here and there, same number of chiral centers are present. So if you count over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13, there are 13 chiral center found in venusal A as well as venusal B. And other important characteristic of venusal A and venusal B, I think how this structure can be converted into some stereo specific point of view, that we will discuss in our next lecture. Still then, have a nice day. Thank you.